topic is linked 107. History of linguistics. Now, last time I met, we talked about the definition of linguistics, definition of language. I'm saying that the history of linguistics started with the historians. We talked about the first types of historians that worked on the concept of linguistics, the study of linguistics. The first people we started with were the, which one? The Babylonian tradition. They were the first that we started with. And in them, we talked about the Sumerian language, the Akkadian language. The next thing we talked about were the words, the Indian or the Hindi tradition. Followed by
the Greek.
You guys didn't work on the Roman tradition, so we left it out. But apart from that, we have the fourth one, which is the Arabic tradition.
The Roman tradition is there.
It's not there.
It's there.
Sure. Let me check. Because what I saw yesterday was Greek tradition. Okay, she did under the Hebrew. It's under the Hebrew. Okay, let's move on. So the Arabic tradition, we said the Arabic tradition, where is it? The Arabic tradition was interested mainly in the perceived notion.
The Arabic Arabians were very much
interested in what?
They perceived as the
harmonious nature of the Arabic language. Now they developed a general theory. They developed a general theory of language and grammar. A general theory of language and grammar, which was contrary. It was contrary to the Greeks, which was contrary to that of the Greeks. It was contrary to that of the Greeks. And they focused, just like the Greeks, on the Arabic. You know, we said the Greeks focused on which language? On their own language. Greek language. They didn't focus on other foreign languages. The Arabic also focused on Arabic. They didn't focus on other languages. They focused on the Arabic language alone. Now they said it is unclear. It is unclear to which extent the Arabic language or the Arabic tradition was being influenced by the Greek. By the Greek philosophy.
To which aspect?
To which extent? Extent. To which extent? The Arabic tradition was influenced by the Greek. Especially when it comes to the Aristotle's teachings. Especially when it comes to the Aristotle's teachings. If you look at the traditions, you will notice that the Babylonian tradition affected the Indian tradition. The Indian tradition, those under the Babylonian, the Sumerian, the Akkadian, they were not about the concept of linguistics. But they focused on what? Phonetics, phonology. The Indians focused on what? Phonetics, phonology, and morphology. The Greek, they went into the parts of speech. Do you understand? Into the parts of speech. Giving the parts of speech. Giving the words and the meaning under nation and convention. That was the Aristotle's teachings. Aristotle focused on the convention aspect, saying that the meanings of the words is based on what the native speakers or what the community says about it. Now, what they are now saying is that the Arabic tradition, they too were influenced, but we cannot say to which extent they were influenced. The only thing is that we know that they were influenced by the Aristotle, more of the Aristotle's teachings. Do you understand? Now, they said, however, the Aristotle's teachings, stimulated the Arabic tradition. It stimulated the Arabic tradition indirectly through the Farsan, The Falsafa is also known as the Greek tradition, another name for the Greek tradition, the Greek philosophy. Now, it was said that in all cases, the purpose of the Arabic grammarians, were extremely different from those of the Greek. The purpose of the Arabic grammarians were extremely different from those of the Greek. What were the purposes of the Greek? The purposes of them bringing about their tradition. What was their notion, the reason why they brought about the Greek tradition?
The study of philosophy,
yes. And nature and convention, you understand? Nature and convention, syntax, the part of speech. But they went in a different direction. The Arabic people went in a different direction. They said the Islamic expansion,
wait, the purpose of the Arabians,
were extremely different from those of the Greeks. Right, we said that the Islamic expansion caused the Arabic language to become a common language, for a large amount of people who were not originally, native speakers of the language. As a result of this, it became obligatory. It became required to describe what classical Arabic. It became required to describe what classical Arabic was in its purest, now I say something, purest, unbastardized form, which was assumed to be the language spoken by, which was assumed to be the language spoken by the camel breeding tribes. The camel breeding tribes. Living camel breeding. Camel breeding tribes. Living in Central Arabia. Living in Central Arabia. Arabic Ghanaians living in Central Arabia. Now, Arabic Ghanaians were primarily, they were mainly preoccupied. Arabic Ghanaians were mainly preoccupied with determining a body of linguistic data that represented the purest classical Arabic form. And also providing the most accurate and relevant description of the language grammar, embedded in the data. One of the most famous works. In Arabic was Ibn Wahb.